What's up, guys? In this video, we will be talking about the future of blockchain. I'm not a professional advisor, but let's get it on. All right, all of the links to the articles that we will be discussing will be in the description of the video. So first things first, what is Web 3.0? So Web 3.0 is a possible future version of the internet based on public blockchains, a record-keeping system best known for facilitating cryptocurrency transactions. The attractiveness of Web 3.0 is that it is decentralized, meaning that rather than consumers accessing the internet through service mediated by companies like Google, Apple, Facebook, individuals themselves own and govern sections of the internet. And we also have an intensive explanation on what Web 3.0 is. Check out our channel for that video. So what is the core of Web 3? So decentralization is a core concept of Web 3 and a fundamental departure from its predecessors in terms of architecture and infrastructure. Now, while Web 1.0 was all about static pages and Web 2.0 saw more dynamic and user-generated content and interactivity, the platform is provided by third parties and in most cases owned by tech giants such as Meta, which is Facebook. You have Twitter, you have Microsoft. However, in Web3, with blockchain technology, data can be stored in a distributed mechanism. In the blockchain, information is encrypted and stored over a network of computers with no central oversight. This means that the data can't be changed arbitrarily since its copies exist across the network. If a copy doesn't match with the rest, it becomes invalid. Now, this adds an extra layer of security which is built in the architecture. And that is actually the main reason why, you know, crypto in general uses Web3 instead of the other Web 1.0 or Web 2.0. So how does the blockchain work? So this is a diagram on how that doesn't work. Now, it doesn't really matter where the server with the data is physically located and who owns it unless the owner of the data consents or there is a network-wide consensus. This data can't be accessed or modified by anyone other than the owner, which again, guys, this is the reason why this is the architecture that is being implemented or used by crypto. Now, I hope that, you know, banks would also implement Web 3.0 instead of the usual ones that they are implementing, because it also enhances the security. Add up the OTP, add up, you know, sending messages to your phone when logging in. That security is very, very good. All right. Next up would be cryptocurrency, NFTs, and DAOs. The fact that Web3 is heavily backed by the cryptocurrency community implies that cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin and NFTs are the non-fungible tokens. If you don't know what a non-fungible token or NFT is, go ahead and check out the channel. There is a video that we created just for that. We'll play a key role in the new internet economy. The concept of the decentralized autonomous organization, otherwise known as DAO, refers to a collective or company without a traditional management structure. The DAO functions according to the rules encoded into the blockchain and could boost innovation and entrepreneurship. These organizations would be collectively owned by shareholders and would be autonomous and transparent in nature, paving the way for creating companies faster and without bureaucratic hurdles or relying on platforms owned by the big tech out there. Okay, so that is your cryptocurrency, your NFTs, and DAOs. Now, finally, all right, AI and metaverse. We also created a video that entirely talks about what AI and metaverse is, so go ahead and check out the channel. Artificial intelligence, otherwise known as AI, is an important component of Web3 as the concept involves a lot of machine-to-machine interactions and autonomous decision-making. Autonomous decision-making meaning no human intervention is needed. So it's more like machine learning in general. So AI algorithms can substitute humans for the performance of various tasks, which is very much in sync with Web3 trends. Like Web3, the metaverse is being predicted as the next iteration of the web. a network of virtual worlds where users can interact using 3D avatars for most collaborative and social activities. You would also be shocked there are properties in there. You have lands, you have vehicles. Depending on what project that is how the metaverse works. So while technologies like virtual reality, you have augmented reality, can provide an immersive and persistent internet, Web3 technologies such as blockchain, you have cryptocurrencies, and NFTs can form the bedrock as well as facilitate interoperability. And in many ways, the metaverse is the front end while Web3 technologies and AI provide the infrastructures and applications. If you are new to the channel, guys, please consider subscribing and clicking that bell. That way you'll always be notified when we upload new videos in the future. I will see you on the next. I'm out. Peace.